Thank you very much. Venerable Chief Wan Lee.
ค่ะและที่จบไปนะคะก็เป็นสารแสดงความยินดีนะคะจากผู้นำชาวพุทธนะคะและผู้นำทางการเมืองของแต่ละประเทศค่ะอย่างที่กล่าวไปเมื่อตอนต้นนะคะว่าวันนี้นะคะทุกท่านจะได้พบกับการปาฐกถาพิเศษค่ะในโอกาสนี้นะคะดิฉันขอเรียนเชิญทุกท่านพบกับการปาฐกถาเรื่องการอนุรักษ์อัตลักษณ์ทางวัฒนธรรมในโลกที่เชื่อมโยงกันโดยวันนี้นะคะเราได้รับเกียรติจากท่านรัฐมนตรีว่าการกระทรวงวัฒนธรรมท่านวีระโรจน์โภชนรัตน์ค่ะขอกราบเรียนเชิญค่ะ
As we informed you earlier that today we will have the special speech by His Excellency Minister of Culture of the Kingdom of Thailand with a great honor I would like to invite His Excellency Wira Roth Phochanarat Minister of Culture of the Kingdom of Thailand to deliver a meaningful speech on preserving cultural identity in an intercontinental world please
The most venerable Professor Dr. Paprom Bandit, Director of MCU, President of the International Council for Day of Vaisak and International Association of Buddhist University. Most venerable, respected venerable, Buddhist scholar, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen,Good afternoon. I'm honored to be here and delight deliver to you my thoughts. And I take a moment to commemorate on why the preservation of cultural identity is crucial to mankind. But first of all, may I take a moment to commemorateThe birth, the enlightenment, and the nirvana of Buddha on the auspicious occasion of the upcoming Vaisak Day or Visakha Bhuja for us. The follower of Lord Buddha, it is an opportunity to recapture humans.Insistent on goodness and also our effort to propagate the path of peace and manness to the world. Therefore, I am thankful for your presence here today. It has been more than 2,500 years since the Buddha created history and the great culture ofMindfulness. The event of his life, which we are now celebrating, are widely recognized as important milestone of history. His birth in Lumpini, in Nepal, his enlightenment in Puttakaya in India, and hisNirvana in Kusinala. These places are important to us and became the cultural landmarks and heritage of the world. The enlightenment of the Buddha has created a culture of knowledge and understanding where human place high importance on the power of the mankind.Not only after his time, educational institutes such as Nalanda and Takshila, where Dhamma was studied and passed on, were established. The well of Dhamma has become the symbol of learning and understanding, and is also a symbol of an effort to have the worldOf Buddha be heard. When knowledge was combined with art, and the following centuries. The age of Buddhist art has started out with Buddhist sculpture inside a large complex, a Buddha heritage in Ajanta Cave. Buddhism traveled throughout the world by taking various routes. For example, the route up north from India to China, including Tibet and Bhutan, and in Tun Huang, which is a crucial spot on the ancient Silk Road, and also Japan and Korea. The Dao to Southeast Asia, where Buddhist monuments stand the test of time, creating phenomenal Buddhist architecture such as Borobudur in Indonesia, where the stone narrating the story of Maya, mother of Buddha, were found, and Angkor Thom complex in Cambodia, which is the largest Buddhist site ever built. Also, Buddhism has flourished in Champa, the kingdom of Vietnam, and also Lao and Myanmar, where Pagan is accounted as the largest Buddhist city in the world. Dhamma also took the southern part, whereby many towns in Sri Lanka, such as Anuradhapura and Polonnaruwa and Dambulla Cave, hold persistent Buddhist cultural influence. Buddhism traveled to Thailand since 1,400 years ago. The first archaeological evidence that held Buddhist significance were found in the central and southern parts of Thailand, and were proved to be those of Thawalawadi and Srivichai Er, such as the masterpiece of sculpture of Bodhisattva, King of Kotabun Kingdom in northeastern Thailand, and Lan Na, Kingdom of Northern Thailand, where the great follower of Buddha, the Kingdom of Sukhothai, which was establishing era of Thai culture, was the golden age of Buddhist sculpture, where artistic perfection and peacefulness meet. And with Buddhism as the ethnic foundation of the kingdom, citizens in Sukhothai were free, spirited, and happy. As the name of the kingdom itself means the dawn of happiness. Then came the first phase of the global interconnectivity. The kingdom of Asia, influenced by the Buddhist teaching to of tolerant, peaceful encounter with foreigner and brought prosperity to Ayutthaya. The city became the international port where Chinese, Portuguese, the Persian, Malayu, the Japanese, the Dutch, the French came to trade and call Ayutthaya their hometown, their home. In line with their trade, Ayutthaya Kingdom was referred to as the golden age of Buddhist architecture. The interconnectedness was reaffirmed in the era of Ratanakosin of Bangkok, as we know it, with 236 years of history. People of Bangkok were excellent at bringing in new ideas of culture from foreign sources and harmoniously integrating with the way of life and existing norm. Today, Bangkok has become a world-class tourist destination with more than 22 million tourists a year. With rich history of cultural identity, Thailand is now focusing on management of cultural heritage as a tool for social and economic development. The old Sukhothai city was preserved and developed with tourist facilities such as hotel and airport, as the yearly Loy Kathong festival is recently added to tourist interest. It generates revenue of 3 billion baht per year. The Ayutthaya Earl, known as the Great Earl of Interconnectedness, where the envoy of France and other Western kingdoms came to visit, is now a national focus. The Royal Brass Procession was sent out to greet the honorable visit, and the envoy were assigned to kingdom. In the west and the east, the record of the life of ordinary Ayutthaya citizens were found and trust. The later generation could benefit from these ancient findings. In Bangkok, the interconnectedness was emphasized through the Siamese royal envoy to Queen Victoria of England and Napoleon III of France. The diplomatic visit of King Rama V to the West, which brought Western artistic influence and technology into the Thai way of life, including architecture and craft. Bangkok has become vivid combination of old and new. As blessed by the cultural treasure from the past, we have preserved and proudly display our tradition to the world. Among many of them is the preservation of Ramayana, the mystery created in India, which has become the common cultural heritage of Southeast Asia in the form of literature, painting, and performance. Other essential traditions such as Songkran, together with royal ceremony such as the royal bus procession and royal plowing ceremony, and well preserved and celebrated. Among royal ceremony that is now the national focus is the royal funeral, where Master of Thai arts celebrate to produce the artwork based on Buddhist philosophy and the traditional architecture and engineering, which have been passed on over 300 years. Moreover, in the era of interconnectivity, Ministry of Culture has been supporting cultural activity in Thai Buddhist temple around the world, with more than 500 existing temple and network of Buddhist forum. So in addition, Ministry of Culture is hosting the New Year Buddhist service every year for people around the world to pray in peace. Also, we are planning to inviting Supreme Patriarch around the world to pray with us in Thailand this New Year. And after having preserving and practiced Buddhism for many centuries, it is now Thailand's turn to spread the Buddhist teaching of peace and kindness to the world as well. And not only preserving cultural identity, Ministry of Culture aim to use the cultural heritage to enhance the economy by following the 5F strategy. 5F is our intention to enhance Thailand's cultural and art production in 5 potential fields, namely food. The Thai food is as artistic statement that convey cultural knowledge. There are more than 17,000 Thai restaurants worldwide. Festival vary in each region of Thailand, and therefore tourists can enjoy festival in Thailand all year round, which will benefit the local economy. And fashion, for the past few decades, we have seen the booming of fashion industry, and Thailand has effort the world is quality fabric. Together with creating design film, Thailand is putting its effort into film production, including the productivity of animation book and program and game. Thai film industry generate more than 40 billion baht each year. Fighting is mean the Muay Thai has now became mainstream in sport culture. More than 10,000 Muay Thai training camp are open around the world. In addition, Ministry of Culture aim to enhance idea and creativity through the art and cultural learning among people. We have operated some improvement in national museum throughout the country. Latest technology such as QR and AR code are used in the display. And moreover, the construction of the latest extension of Thailand Cultural Center is aimed at being a global cultural service complex, and Thailand as a center of art in the international level, added to the preservation work is our intention to use cultural heritage creatively by prompting the project such as construction of Thai pavilion in foreign country, the nomination of World Heritage Site, and the registration of 3 that hold cultural and commercial value. This work can inspire the younger generation to preserve their identity and benefit from Thai culture when living in the world that is interconnected and moving with fast pace. It is known fact that cultural identity could be best for the national progress. I would like to point out that our effort to enlarge the cultural industry has a positive result. Thailand has been placing in list of international survey, such as numbers 26 on the list of best country, number 1 in Asia's tourist destination, and number 1 on the list of global tourist destination, and number 7 on the list of the country with most outstanding culture, with cultural heritage stream from the foundation, Buddhist practice and philosophy. Thailand will achieve the sustainable development by the use of art and culture and the propagate of the peaceful path in of to the people around the world. Thank you very much. ขอบคุณมากครับ
กราบขอบพระคุณค่ะ
Thank you very much, His Excellency Vira Roth Pojanarat, Minister of Cultural Ministry, to refer a very, very meaningful speech.
ค่ะขอขอบพระคุณนะคะท่านวีระโรจน์พจนารัตน์รัฐมนตรีว่าการกระทรวงวัฒนธรรมนะคะที่ได้มากล่าวปาฐกถาในวันนี้ค่ะและขอกราบอาราธนาพระเดชพระคุณศาสตราจารย์ดร.พระพรหมบัณฑิตมอบของที่ระลึกค่ะ
I would like to humbly invite the most venerable Professor Dr. Prapama Pandit, Rector of Mahajalalongkorn Raja Vidyalaya University, President of ICDV and IABU to kindly present a souvenir toHis Excellency Vira Roth Pojanarat.
ขอกราบขอบพระคุณท่านรัฐมนตรีเป็นอย่างสูงนะคะและในลำดับถัดไปค่ะจะเป็นการรายงานผลการประชุมทางวิชาการค่ะ
Next the program presented to you is the report of panel discussions taken place on 26 at Mahajalalongkorn Raja Vidyalaya Wang Noi Ayutthaya that we would like to inviteVenerable Dr. Pati Thammaratana, Vice President of International Council for the Day of Vesak, to be the moderator of the panel discussion report. Please, Venerable Sir.
ค่ะในโอกาสนี้นะคะดิฉันขอกราบอาราธนาพระดร. ทีธรรมรัตนะรองประธานสภาสากลวันวิสาขบูชาโลกทำหน้าที่ผู้ดำเนินรายการค่ะขอกราบอาราธนาค่ะ
Yeah, please, Venerable Sir.